I have read two articles from the magazine Caravan about the death of Judge Loya in December 2014. I have also seen the recorded video recorded testimonies of his family members. I think his two sisters gave their version. One is a teacher, the other is a doctor, and his father also appears in the video. And his father is an 85-year-old man. It seems that Loya has a son of some. He must be very young at that time. He doesn't appear before the camera, but his letter is given to the journalist, and that letter shows that the son of Judge Loya requested the then Chief Justice of Bombay High Court to carry an investigation into his unfortunate death in Nagpur. Now, the official version is that the Judge Loya died of heart attack, cardiac arrest, they said. He was in Nagpur and he passed away there. He was taken to some hospital called Dande Hospital, and from there to some other hospital. And his body was brought to his native place, that is, I just don't remember the name of the place. And his family says, and particularly the doctor's sister, who says there were blood stains on his clothes. Then she says that the way the clothes were, they were in a very different manner. I mean there was something odd about the way the clothes, the body was found. Then she also points out that the postmortem examination report is signed by a person, some unknown person, as the cousin of the deceased judge. They don't have any relation in Nagpur, and they don't have any cousin residing in Nagpur. Then another circumstance which according to them is suspicious is one Mr. Baheti, who had no concern with the family, and he's a completely stranger, and he came on the scene. He was there all along. He returned the mobile of the judge 3 or 4 days after his death. And according to them, the messages in mobile are deleted. So the family claims that there was some message sent to the judge that he should be cautious, and there some sort of a warning to him. And this was also deleted. It was not there. Family knew about it. It appears that the judge was handling a very high profile case against a influential politician during that time. And according to the family, the judge during that time was rather stressed, because according to them, the judge was being pressurized to decide the matter in a particular way. And the family claims that it was a high functionary of the Bombay High Court who was pressurizing him and influencing the outcome of the case. And also he was offered a huge bribe. It was also said he was asked whether he would like to have any flat or land in Mumbai. This is what the family claims, that the judge shared this information with them. And particularly, he told his father that he would not succumb to this any pressure, and perhaps he would quit and come back to their native place and start farming. This is what the family claims. Now, this occurred in 2014, and then perhaps, I mean, at that time, if the son had made a request for investigation, some sort of investigation ought to have ordered. But now, with these allegations, I feel it is very necessary that the CJ of the High Court or the CJ himself should look into this material, should decide whether to hold order an inquiry, because if these allegations are not investigated, it really causes, I mean, a serious stigma on the judiciary. I mean, it is, see, as it is in recent times, I mean, there are several self-inflicted wounds on the judiciary, and I feel that such matters should be investigated. Now, how one can decide about the investigation or appointing a commission, I mean, that's a matter to be decided by the CJ of the High Court or the CJI. I made some inquiries, and I was told that he was a very honest and upright judge. He was a senior member of the district judiciary, and not inquiring into the allegations made by the family, not addressing their grievances, would send a very wrong signal to the judiciary, particularly to the lower cadre. You see, recently there are several incidents tend to dent the image of the judiciary. So in all these cases, actually, if there is some prima facie material to investigate into, it is absolutely necessary to order an inquiry and it is also necessary for even the persons against whom the allegations are made, because it's necessary to clear their names also. I make it very clear that I'm not expressing any opinion on these allegations made by the family, but they are serious enough to be investigated into. Now, how this investigation to be done, whether any commission to be set up for that, I mean, that's a matter to be decided by the judiciary. But I mean, judiciary is the tallest institution in the country, and the people have tremendous faith in the judiciary. So in any kind of this incident, any misgivings of a family, of a member of the judiciary, should be addressed. I mean, there should be some investigation into it.